Everybody ready? Okay, coach. All right, new week. Football team is getting ready for ULM. Louisiana-Monroe coming here this week. Had a good practice yesterday. Worked well, had a good film session. Seen some good things in the ball game the other day. Also seen some bad things. Let's say bad, just being more consistent in our techniques and fundamental things that we could do. We could be so much better there, and we can help our players as coaches being in those positions so that they can make the play. But saw some good things that we can build off of. Like I said, Saturday night, one game was not defining this football team. We'll work really hard to get this thing turned around, and we will.
Start with Chantel.
I can hear you, Chantel.
You guys talked about the D-line, got that pressure you had been talking about last week. Just having gone back and looked at film, what were you able to see from your DBs? Because Bachmar was still able to complete a number of 15, 20-yard passes. So what were you able to see from your DBs, and what do you still need to see from them?
Well, I thought in that game, I thought we pressured them. We played really good defense. You know, and then when we sat back and we became a little passive, that's what he completed a lot of passes in the ball game. And unfortunately, a lot of them was third and long. Our defense did a good job of first and second down to get them in those situations. And then on third down, we did pressure. And he completed some passes in there. And again, we gotta be better fundamentally and technically in order to defend those plays. Coaching and that's guys taking coaching and applying it on the football field.
Jane?
Coach, keeping it on defense, and some of those, you mentioned some of those third longs, and it seemed like guys were getting pretty open on those plays. Was it a schematic thing? Were guys just breaking down? Was it communication? When you went back and looked at the film, what were you seeing on those plays?
Well, I think it was part schematic and part of it not putting enough pressure on the court. He had a lot of time. And usually when you have a lot of time, somebody's going to get open. And that's what happened. We gave him too much time. You know, we pressured him throughout the game. We made bad throws and we allowed him too much time to scramble around and find somebody open. And we were scrambling around. We should have plastered a little better as DBs, meaning staying with our receivers. And we lost him at times when we didn't pressure him. He had time to throw the ball.
Chris in the front row.
Continuing that theme, do you consider a departure from the scheme? Do you stick to the scheme and work on technique and fundamentals, or is it kind of meeting those two in the middle somewhere?
Well, I think we got to look at that game and look at what we did well and what we did bad, and make sure we get rid of the things we did bad if it's not going to help us, and then continue to do the things that we did well. Like I said, when we put pressure on him, we hit the kid quite a bit, and when we put pressure on him, he didn't complete a lot of balls, you know, so I think part of it is understanding, again, ourselves, us as coaches and our players, understand what we're good at and be good at that and do it, you know, and things that we're not good at, don't put our guys in that position to be bad at it. So, like I said, the other day, it was a good film to learn from everybody, coaches and players, you know, but there's some things that, you know, we got to get rid of it. There's a lot of good things that we can continue to do, and if we would in that game, it probably would have helped us.
Go over to Sean over on your right.
Coach, something that had a lot of people surprised, especially with the size that you have up front, was how much success Boise State had running the football. Mm-hmm. Just going back and looking at tape, what did you see that were issues, and how can you fix that?
Alignment, and like I said earlier, fundamentals, you know, tackling. You got to be good at tackling, but I thought a big part of it was alignment. I mean, it all starts with that. Again, we got to do a better job as coaches to make sure our guys are lined up exactly where they're supposed to be, and then be fundamentally sound and do what they have to get the job done. You know, but after watching the film, a lot of it was alignment, and I guess you could say assignment when guys aren't in their gap. You know, if you ask a D lineman to move and he's supposed to be in the gap, we need to make sure that he's in that gap. Or if we ask a linebacker to be in the gap, then we need to make sure he's in that gap. And there was time when we wasn't in the gap.
see a lot of rotation at in games at the college level. You guys played 10 offensive linemen in the game. Just what's the idea behind that, and how did you think it worked?
Well, I wouldn't necessarily say it was an idea behind it. We had some guys go down. Some guys got hurt throughout the game, and when somebody get hurt, you got to bring someone else in, and that's what we did. You know, I think with the rotation with Dante Lucas and Mike Arnold, that was planned. We're going to give Mike some reps in there and give Dante a breather, which he probably needed. There was a couple times there where he made some mistakes, which we knew was going to happen at some point throughout the game. You know, but when Brady got hurt on one play there, and I say hurt, he came back. Thing that happened to a couple of guys where they were hurt and came back.
Corey?
Lou, what did you see from James from first half to second half? Why wasn't he able to get back to what he looked like in the first half?
Well, first half, made some good plays. Second half, I think it had to do with the entire offense, not just James, just everybody being on the same page. You know, the first half, we executed a lot better. We were more on the same page. The second half, we didn't do that. And I thought our guys pressed a little more in the second half when things didn't go right there. The first couple of series, we started to press to try to make plays, and rather than just trusting the process and doing their assignments. And so with James, I thought it was more of that. Now, he missed some reads. He missed some adjustment that is critical to what we do offensively. He missed a couple of those. And then there was some things where I thought we can put our players in a better situation, too, to help ourselves. So, again, it was good to see the film, see the things that we did well and the things that we did wrong, and now we can correct those things. And I can say, too, just being in this game, the first game, with Coach Browse, I think there's going to be some good and some bad, and then we can learn from those things. But I think as an offense, you'll see it continue to improve and be better. And as a team, I think you'll see us improve and be better throughout an entire football game.
Tim?
I know with the style of offense, you probably expect time of possession to be skewed to the other side a lot, but is that something that you'd like to see balanced out a little bit more, or something that you concern yourself with as the game's going on?
Well, I think it's easy to sit here and say that, you know, with them having 40 minutes, it's because we go fast, we're off the field. It's easy to sit here and say that, but we look at the reality of it. They were in 19 third down situation and converted 10. You know, you got to get off the field on third down. And that's how we get more time of possession, you know. And also, there in the second half, we got to convert offensively. Stay out of the third longs and convert. So I wouldn't say it because of offense. I think it's both. You know, we got to convert on those third down, but defensively we got to get off the field. You know, we can't give up 10 third down. Period.
You talked a little bit about conditioning on Saturday and just how you need to know who to put out when and how to keep guys fresh. How do you guys kind of manage that moving forward?
We condition almost every day, so we're going to continue to do that. That's the important. And again, we just got to be smart on our substitution and when and how we do those things, you know, and put our heads together, the staff, and make sure we go out and do a good job of making sure that our guys are fresh when they go out there.
Corey?
Willie, when you make a big change defensively and go more to a 3-4, and then the first game you give up what you gave up, 38 first downs and 600 yards. Is it hard not to say, man, maybe this was a mistake? Let's go back to what we did last year. How do you stick with it? How do you keep yourself from not maybe panicking about it, and the players from believing and not having doubt about the defense?
Well, I think you watch the film and you see what you did wrong, and the film doesn't lie. So we watch the film and trust our technique and our training and what we're doing. Again, I don't think the scheme was the issue. I think it's more fundamentals and technique and alignment. And I know we say go from 3-4. If you go back and watch the film, you, you go back, you see we're in a lot more even front. We wasn't as much 3-4, so it's not as much different than what we did last year. I think a big part of it is alignment assignment. We got to be gap sound, period. And when you saw those crease that they got, you know, the big runs that we caught, we weren't in our gaps. And those things that we can coach and correct, you know. And I think come next week, you'll see us be much better at those things.
I guess I'll go ahead, sorry. I was going to ask about Carlos Becker, saw him come off the edge a couple of times on blitz. I guess, how did you see him fitting in that role? And second, he's a guy who's been injured a lot. We just haven't seen him through the years for various reasons. How has he kind of progressed and fought through those injuries?
Thank you. Carlos has just grown up, sort of like our football team. And you know, some guys develop a little, take them a little longer than others. See, with Carlos, he had been injured, so it was hard for him to get a lot of work and a lot of development in because he was injured. And this offseason was his first healthy offseason, and he was able to work out the entire time. He was able to go through spring ball and have the whole summer and training camp, and he made it through it injury-free, and that helped him from a development standpoint big time. But I think Carlos has gained a lot of confidence in himself. Throughout training camp, what we saw on Saturday, he started to make those plays throughout training camp and started to get the confidence of his coaches and his teammates. And so it was good to see him do it in the game, you know, because he had been doing it in practice. And good to see a young man go through some things and come out and make some plays.
Ira?
Well, you guys played some really young guys on defense. How did they do, Amari and Renardo Green and
Mari did some good things. The one I was really impressed with was Ricardo Green. I thought he played really well when he got in the game. He played with some attitude. He was playing physical. He was playing smart, instinctively. He's one of those freshmen over the last 2 weeks of training camp really came along and really stepped his game up. And the last two scrimmages that we had, he had really stepped up, which made him go up on a depth chart. And I thought he played really well.
He's a physical guy. He's physical, isn't he?
Yeah, he loves contact. He's not afraid of contact. And we saw it there on one of his plays, he came up and made a tackle. But that's Ricardo. I think he's going to be a really good player for us.
Brendan?
Will, you were able to get a bunch of young guys in on defense, but it seemed like there was a ton of substituting within drive to drive. Is that something, when you talk about conditioning or substitutions, that you guys may look at that altering a little bit?
Again, we're going to be better when it comes to substitution and making sure that we're good with it. But same thing there. We had some guys that went out in that game, so some of them had to play, you know, and then we're pretty young back there, so there's a lot of young guys had to play in. Making sure that we're keeping them fresh as well. But I think overall we stayed healthy. We probably wouldn't have seen as much substitution as we did.
And then one young guy I guess we didn't see dressed out was Travis Jay. Was that injury or something else? And then what's his status moving forward?
It wasn't an injury, it was something else. And he's working, going through some things, and hopefully we'll get Travis back out there ASAP.
Tim?
You had, I think, 6 sacks from 5 different players for pass rush. I mean, is that kind of what you had in mind? I know preseason you said that, or Coach Barnett was saying that he liked that you don't know where the pressure's coming from. And I guess is that type of success something that group can build on, you think?
I do. You know, again, like I mentioned earlier, when we did those things, we had success on defense. You know, it was playing time where we had them in third and long was because of the success that we had on first and second down. And a lot of that was some of the blitzing that we were doing. We got to be better as third down, you know. And if it works, keep doing it, you know, until they stop it. You know, and I think when we stop pressure, that's when they got some play. So, but yes, that's something we can build off of, something that's going to help our guys defensively.
Pat.
Coach, there are some guys like Dennis Briggs that flash from time to time, and
was fairly impressive. Is there any plan to get him and Marvin on the field at the same time after what you've seen on film?
I wouldn't necessarily say there's a plan to get them both on the field at the same time. There could be times where they're out there at the same time, but our plan is just to continue to develop Dennis and for him to continue to get better. And we all thought as a staff, he was going to be one of the players this year that was going to really help his football team. And he had some good plays as a freshman last year, and we expect a lot out of Dennis this year. And I can see him again as that season go on, we're going to continue to see him get better.
As long as back.
You mentioned learning how to win. These players need to learn how to win. There's so many of them came from successful high school programs. They won state championships. It's obviously a different level, but is there something they need to relearn or something you guys can key on to help them learn how to win again?
I mean, it's all of them. I mean, they came from successful high school, and they were around a lot of people who won, you know, and now you just look at our football team, you know, over the last 2 years, or you just look at our juniors, you know, those guys that's junior now, they hadn't won a lot and hadn't won like they expected to win when they decided to come here and what we expect for the state to be. So getting our guys back in that mindset and the little things that it takes to win, we got to be taught how to do that again. You know, I will say our guys we're better as a football team. Getting to that point, you know, just things we got to continue to learn. For instance, like when you got a team, you're up on a team, you got to put your foot on the throat and you got to finish the ball game. And our guys got to understand that. That's another part of the process that we're doing and building our program back. And our guys are getting better at it. And again, I think that's something we'll learn from. And I think if we're in that situation again, I think our guys will come through it. Make it happen.
To Sean.
Coach, looking ahead to Louisiana-Monroe, I know a lot of people are kind of assuming that you guys are going to win that game. I think something that we saw similar last year, hitting the game against Sanford, and then we ended up seeing some of the issues from week one carry over to week two. I guess, how do you kind of avoid that hangover from week to week and maybe overlooking that?
Well, one thing we're not going to do is focus on what happened last year, you know, and we're going to correct the things that we did wrong last week and go out and be better, us as coaches and players. You know, we're going to know our assignments, and we're going to make sure we put our players in the best position to go out and execute those assignments. And we're going to try to go out and play our best ball game as a football team. We have to and find a way to win this ball game and play a clean ball game. And
I think I got it. Wayne?
Coach, you had a lot of success running the football in the first half. Stalled out in the second. After watching the film, what do you think you guys did well in the first half, and what went wrong in the second?
We gave the ball to Cam in the first half. Second half, we didn't give it to him. So, get the ball to Cam, get the ball to Kaylin. We got some really good running backs. Give them the ball. They can run the ball. They're pretty good.
Hey, Willie, kind of following off of Wayne's question, after the game you talked about trying to get the offense back into rhythm in the second half when things did stall. In hindsight, I guess, what are a few things that you'd like to see more of to get that rhythm back in the future if something like that happens?
Find different ways to run the ball, you know, and so we can give all our secrets, but we got to be able to run the football, period. You know, whether it's first half, second half, we got to be able to run the football. We got guys that can run the football, and yeah, we got to make sure we're putting our guys in a position to be able to do those things to have some success. And I mean, you saw in the first half, you know, we run the ball well, we move the ball. And so I think it all starts with that. And we got to continue to find different ways to run the ball.
Sorry, Derek. Were some of there was a lot of deep passes and fairly consecutive drives too. Is that something that James has the freedom to do, or is that something that was dialed up, I guess?
That was part of the RPO thing that we're doing, and again, we got to make sure that we, in certain situations, we put him in a position to where he has some options and not be locked into one guy. And I think that happened a couple of times there on those third and long where he had some run pass options and they made us throw the ball and cover. So, we can, like I said, with that area, somewhere we can be better at it. We looked at it as a staff. And I think you'll see that part.
Well, yeah, two-part question. Did the offensive line play well enough for you guys to do what you want to do on offense? And also, how did Brady come out after the game physically?
We played well enough. Did we play like we want to? No. But again, I see that group continue to get better as the year goes on. I don't think you'll see that group. I do think we're better than what we were. And you'll continue to see them get better as we keep going on as the season, as they get to play with each other. I think you're going to constantly see that improve. Brady, he's back in practice yesterday. He tweaked his knee in the game, but he practiced yesterday, so he's back. But as a group, yeah, I thought we were better. We could be better than what we showed on Saturday. And I do think Coach Clements, he got a chance to see what his guys in action, you know, and get a chance to see again what we're good at, what we're not good at. And we can make some changes, not necessarily changes, but some adjustments to help us.
Corey? Lou, when you mentioned the alignment issues you had on defense, was that stuff that was happening in practice too, or was that more just a surprise during the game?
It was more during the game. I don't think it was something in practice. We wouldn't did it in the game if it was in practice. I just think it was one of those first games, and again, guys got a lot of juiced up and just, again, lose focus. It's just lack of focus from the...
Just lack of focus?
Again, it was, I think guys were just juiced up too much in that game. I don't know if juiced up the right word for it or not, but we lost a lot of focus. And just from, an alignment standpoint, and if you're not lined up right, I mean, you're going to find yourself in trouble. I don't care how talented you are. You know, so when I say lined up, sometimes we're too deep, you know, and safeties need to be a little tighter, you know, at times, or back. Linebacker need to be over, or safety need to be in a certain gap, you know. So that's what I mean by alignment thing. But like I said, all those things that we did wrong, they're correctable. Those are things that we can correct ASAP. They're not things that's going to take time to correct. Those things they got corrected yesterday. And again, I think you'll see a difference come this week.
Time for a couple more. Wayne?
Coach, game notes listed set of no coaches in the no defensive coaches in the box. How was the communication between the defensive coaches during the game about what was going on and what they were seeing? And is there any thoughts to getting one of those coaches up in the box?
Actually, you must got a little. You got a good source, or you got some in my office. We were talking about that as a defensive staff. Again, just ways of where we could be better throughout the game. I don't think it was a lack of communication. I thought communication was distributed throughout the coaches. Seeing them on the sideline and drawing up the plays and things for our guys, that was being done the right way. I think, again, once you go through a game like that, you evaluate everything. You want to make sure we put people in the right place to be able to get the job done.
Corey? When Keyshawn calling the fair catches on kickoffs, is that up to him? Y'all tell him beforehand? Does he judge the flight of the ball and then decide? Because he did run one of them out, but he fair called eight other ones.
Yeah, we told him to. We told him when and when we didn't want him to. Just part of the strategy thing.
Oh, yeah.
All right, last one.
When you talk about guys maybe not being lined up correctly, is there any way that, is there like a quarterback on the defense? Is that even possible? Or somebody that should be looking out for other guys? Does there need to be more communication? Or do guys just have to get it right?
You got to do your job. You just got to do your job. The communication is going to come with the checks and things that you make. But lined up, that's your job. You got to do that. You know, and like I said, I think it was more one of those first game things. I think it's a good problem. We see that again. And I don't think you'll see that again.